skated.
Morning from the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia, where we are underway for the final day of the RBC Day of Champions. And the female Adam A division on the ice this morning. The Antigonish Bulldogs facing off against the Valley Wild deep in the Wild Zone right now. Cameron McCacken along with you on 5 TV1, brought to you by Bell Alliance. After 2 days of excellent action here in Bridgewater, we are into our final day. Bulldogs here, deep in their own zone, trying to clear this one out. Bulldogs skating this one out from behind the goal. Thrown up to the blue line and out, and giving chase here is Jenna Beaton in for the Bulldogs. Loses the handle though, and the Valley Wild will turn this one back around and up the ice. Here come the Wild. Sparks in, fires that one, kicked aside. Big save there by Elsa Cameron. In goal for the Antigonish Bulldogs this morning. Bulldogs now up the ice. Brooklyn Chisholm with the puck. Chisholm across the line, backhands that one. It'll roll into the corner. Bulldogs forechecking, but it's the Wild coming away with it now. It's Sparks. Kanaya Sparks crosses the blue line, walks in with a shot, and she scores. Firing that one top shelf. The Valley Wild with a huge goal from their captain, Tania Sparks. Less than 5 minutes into this first period, and the Wild lead 1-0. For Valley as the Bulldogs carry this one offside. So Tania Sparks getting the Valley Wild onto the board here first this morning. 1-0 lead. This Adam A female division. A championship game here at the RBC Day of Champions. Bulldogs in over the line here, walking in with a shot, and that one is knocked high and wide by Connell between the pipes for Valley. Good shot there on the rush by Ailey Glenn. And now face off in the Valley zone. Sparks again with it. Kanaya Sparks loses that one. It's picked off and turned back the other way, walking in with that one. The Bulldogs, number 11. That is Elizabeth McCackern with a nice stop in the neutral zone and a good rush there to push it right back up the ice and an opportunity for the Bulldogs. Another faceoff to come now to the right of Connell in the Valley zone. Boyd in to take that one for the Bulldogs. She wins it over to her winger, and that one rolls into the corner now. Boyd can't keep that one in. Gets to the blue line, but not out. Backhanded in by Ross. Working down low. And that one comes back to the blue line there. Nice pass right to the slot. And that shot by Boyd goes wide. Boyd again trying to rip that one. A couple of good looks for Lacey Boyd here in the early going. Sparks now back up the ice. Tania Sparks. Boyd carrying it through the neutral zone for the Bulldogs. Lacey Boyd once again trying to fire that one on goal, and she buries her own rebound. And the Antigonish Bulldogs have tied this game. Lacey Boyd following up on her shot. The initial shot stopped by the defender's stick. She walked right in, picked that one up, and fired it home. Made no mistake. 8:20 to go here in the first period, and we have a tie game between the Bulldogs and the Wild in Bridgewater. The Bulldogs even here as that one's played through the Wild crease. Play along the near wall, battling for it. It finally comes out into the neutral zone, but the Bulldogs have it again. Board battle along the walls here. No one able to retrieve that puck out into open ice, but it's dumped down into the Bulldogs' defensive zone now. Around the boards. And fired towards the net there. Takes a hop in front, and now the Bulldogs trying to once again relieve the pressure and exit the zone. That one turned over there. Pellrine giving chase. The collision between a couple of Bulldogs down below the goal line. That puck thrown to the line but not out. It's going to be backhanded down low there.
Come on, girls, get on it!
And again, the Bulldogs trying to vacate the defensive zone here. A shot by Venny was deflected there. Puck loose in the Valley zone, and here's Sparks back to collect it. Sparks through the neutral zone. And now over the blue line, and walks Sparks, the goal scorer already in this game for Wild, and she scores again. Winding and weaving through the neutral zone and all the way to the goal mouth for the second goal of the game for Tania Sparks as the Valley Wild regain the lead 2-1 over the Antigonish Bulldogs here. 6:06 to play in the first. And that may not be the last we see out of Sparks here this morning. She's back in. chasing that one. It's chopped down low into the Bulldog zone. Fired off the boards there as Antigonish tries to come up with that one. Here's Glenn. Up ice and across the blue line there for the Bulldogs. Haley Glenn throwing that one towards the goal, and it was almost there for Elizabeth McCackern to tap home. McCackern now back with the puck. Going to move that one up the wall back to Glenn. Haley Glenn losing that one in the neutral zone. McCackern steps up with a play on the puck and fires that one back down into the Wild zone. That puck right around the benches there during a line change for both teams. And the Bulldogs with it again now. Boyd, the goal scorer, up the middle. Puck sitting in the slot there. Boyd trying to throw that one towards the goal, but it's played to the wall by the Valley defender, Vene. Poke check there, and the Bulldogs manage to maintain possession in the zone, attacking zone. Back there for Arsenault, who passes that one cross ice. Burke backhands it into the neutral zone for Boyd. And now it's Lacey Boyd again. Cutting towards the middle, Boyd tries to take a shot, and a nice defensive play on that one by Ella Marshall for Valley. Scramble along the wall, and Valley comes out with that one. It's fired down into the neutral zone. And out into open ice now. A cross ice pass here for Boyd. Lacey Boyd with the puck, a nice move at the blue line. Goes right back towards the center of the ice for the Bulldogs. And backhanded into the slot there. Mary Kate Burke with a good opportunity to try to one-time that one. Fanned on it. The shot there turned aside. And into the middle again for Boyd, who fires that one. It's going to be picked off again by Marshall with another nice defensive play. Up the wall and now out into the neutral zone, where it's stopped by the Bulldogs, and Burke will give that one a little extra boost on the way out of the zone. It'll be blown down for an offside. 3:16 to play here in the first. The Valley Wild leading the Antigonish Bulldogs by a score of 2-1. Watch Inside AUS on TV1 for a look at the players, coaches, and administrators that make Atlantic University Sport the ultimate student-athlete experience. Inside AUS is available to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401 and at tv1.bellalliant.ca. 5 TV1 brought to you by Bell Alliant. Bulldogs now, or sorry, Valley with Ross leading the charge. That shot rolls into the corner there. Digging it out, here comes the Bulldogs. Jenna Beaton plays that one into the neutral zone, where it's going to be picked up again by Sparks. Wheeling here. Already with a couple of goals in this first period is Tania Sparks. That puck comes back to the blue line and fired in by Valley, but now it's the Antigonish Bulldogs skating with it over the blue line there. A nice pass to herself by Allie Pellrine over the blue line and into the attacking zone of for the Antigonish Bulldogs, but turned over now. There's Jean firing that one towards the goal. Back into the neutral zone now.
Pick it up, let's go.
This is Cheek trying to make a play with the puck by for Valley. Now weaving through the neutral zone, here's Glenn. Haley Glenn deep into Valley territory. That shot misses and rolls all the way around, where it's going to be picked up by Ross and carried out here. Sierra Ross loses the handle over the blue line, and the Bulldogs will clear the zone here. All the way back there for Cheek. Kearns and tries to fire that one out into the neutral zone, is successful. There's McCackern, but McDonald still offside on that play. A minute 12 to play here. Off one by the Wild just outside their defensive zone and dumps down the ice. McCackern back to collect now for the Bulldogs. Elizabeth McCackern skating with it. Lots of speed here through the neutral zone. McCackern walking in, takes it to the backhand and tries to tuck that one home, but it's Emily Connell standing tall in the Valley Wild net to maintain this one goal lead. Less than a minute to play now in the first period of play. Some great wheels there by Elizabeth McCackern, but good job by Connell to stay with that puck, track it across the crease and make the save. 52 seconds on the clock with a faceoff to Connell's left. That one picked up and fired on goal by Boyd, and Connell again with the save. She'll cover up for another whistle. 44 and a half to play in the first period. Shots on goal, 7-5 in favor of the Antigonish Bulldogs. They trail this one, 2-1 to Valley. And Boyd to take the draw once again for the Bulldogs. She'll face off against the other goal scorer in this game, Sparks. She's got both goals for the Wild. Played back to the line, but not out. And dumped in deep again there by the Bulldogs. Puck in the center of the ice, and that's going to be taken away now and skated out by McCory. And again dumped back into the Valley end. Ella Marshall making a pass there. Sparks now with the puck. Sparks trying to get loose. And that will do it for period number one. So the Antigonish Bulldogs outshoot Valley by a couple, 7-5, but it's the Valley Wild with the lead, 2-1 after one period of play in this game. Both goals coming from their captain, Tania Sparks. Antigonish goal scorer was Lacey Boyd. We'll get a quick break here as teams regroup and get set for the second period of play. This is the female Adam A. Provincial Championship game here at the RBC Day of Champions, kicking off our final day of action here. We've seen lots of play in the boys' divisions. Adam and Midget on Friday nights. Pee-wee Bantam and a little more Midget last night. And now today, the ladies take the stage. Beginning with this Adam A final. Adam Double A to follow. Then Pee-wee A, Bantam A, and Midget A to round out the Day of Champions. Five games on the schedule today. Number one is back underway here in the second period of play, and the Bulldogs have the puck in the Valley zone. Played towards the goal, and a backhand play there, knocking that one in. Or, no, that was a heck of a save there. That looked like it might have squeaked through, but another big save by Emily Connell. And goal for the Valley Wild. A good opportunity, certainly, for Emerson McDonald to try to chip that one through while seated, but couldn't quite find the back of the net. Face off. Controlled now by the Bulldogs in the attacking zone. Thrown towards the goal there by Beaton and covered up again by Connell. For another draw in Valley territory. beaten. Won the faceoff, but it's going to be dumped down the ice by Valley, and back to chase that one there, the Bulldogs. Pellerine the first one to reach it, but it goes all the way for an icing call. 38 seconds into this second period of action here at the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia, the scene of the action all weekend long here, and has been a wonderful host. Glenn in to take the draw here against Sparks for Valley. The Bulldogs coming up with that one. That'll be dumped in deep. Fired around the boards now by Marshall. With some room for Valley to skate it out. It's turned over instead. Back in the neutral zone. Here's Sparks trying to chip that one to open ice. And now McCackern. Elizabeth McCackern with the puck. Good control of it. And that one will roll into the corner. Here's McCackern once again. But she can't find a handle on that one. And now it's Sparks over the line. McCackern, though, gets back and makes the defensive play on Sparks to break that one up. Valley throwing it deep in behind the goal. Fire towards the goal. Marshall just wide on that attempt. And then attempt to play that one in front was Galloway. Back to the line and not out. And picked up now in front of the goal by the Dogs. And not connecting on that pass. It's back into Valley possession and fired into the Bulldog zone. They clear it right back out. And that's an icing call. 13:08 to play here in period number two. TV One is proud to be the official live stream broadcaster for the 2017 Hockey Nova Scotia RBC Day of Champions from the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. 5 TV One, brought to you by Bella Lines. Face-off one through the legs there by Boyd. Boyd now creates a breakaway for herself. In walks Boyd. Fired on goal, and that one will trickle through. The Antigonish Bulldogs tie the game on Lacey Boyd's second of the morning. As efforts come, they don't get more individual than that one. Boyd pushing the face-off draw, puck right through the legs of her opponent in her own zone after that icing call. Picked it up and skated it all the way down the ice to bury one and tie this game, and Boyd is back on it into the neutral zone. Dogs back for that one and fired up the wall by Pinkos. And here's Boyd again, carrying it over the line. Lacey Boyd looking for some room. That one's thrown on goal. And that'll be swallowed up by Emily Connell and held on to for another draw in the Wild end. 12:26 to play in a tie game now. Again, Lacey Boyd. So we've got four goals and two goal scorers. Sparks with a pair for Valley. And Boyd with two for the Bulldogs. We have us knotted up here. Face off one and fired in behind the net there. That's Marshall playing it up the wall. It's not corralled there by Forsyth. And the Bulldogs keep it in the zone. Into the middle of the ice. That one chipped towards the goal, but it's wide. And back down into the corner now where the Wild will again attempt to clear this one out. Again kept in. The Bulldogs with a chance in the slot there. Couldn't find the handle on it. Good opportunity in tight for Mary Larratt.
Go.
Sparks in deep, chasing that one for Valley. And following it up the half wall where the Bulldogs battled to get that one back. Beaton in there, digging for it. And thrown towards the goal, but deflected away. That's going to be a penalty call for a trip against Valley. So Bulldogs will head to a power play opportunity here as that one carried over offside. 11-11 on the clock. And the wish for the Bulldogs, another goal here on this power play. Dogs out shooting Valley 11-5 in this one so far, and heading to the power play situation. McCachran gets the puck off the draw and skates it in over the line. Elizabeth McCachran playing that one behind the goal and fired right into the goal mouth. Opportunity there, rolls wide. Good heads up play by Emerson McDonald to play that one in front with some traffic there. And Wild clearing that one down the ice to kill another few seconds off of this power play here. 90 seconds remaining in the Antigonish advantage. Glenn over the line with speed, walking in and firing right on goal, but a nice save there by Emily Connell. Good rush by Ailey Glenn. And the Bulldogs, another great opportunity there on the power play with a faceoff to the left of Connell. Sparks walks through on that face-off and tries to carry it out, but it'll be kept in. Glenn now with the puck, hanging on to it and firing that one just wide of the far side. Glenn back with it, trying to stick handle in deep. It'll be dumped in there by McCachran. See Bulldogs go for a change. Tried to find Sparks with that pass. Didn't connect. Here's McCachran now. Elizabeth McCachran trying to fire that one up the wall. And turned over now to Sparks. McCachran takes another whack at it, but that's going to be a penalty call. And we'll get a little bit of four-on-four action here for about 34 seconds before it'll be a power play opportunity for the Valley Wild. So McCachran heads off. Tried to regain possession of that puck and swept the legs. She'll sit for two in the faceoff in the Bulldog zone. Sparks wins that draw clean. Back to Marshall, who throws it to the half wall. Bulldogs are first to it. And skating that one now, Ross opening up a little bit of space, still with it. Ross over the blue line. Four on four action coming to an end here after a nice rush by Ross, who fired that one on goal. And now with the player out of the box, it's a power play opportunity for Valley. Sparks firing that one towards the goal. Bulldogs will clear the zone now. That one's going to be skated on out by Boyd. Still with it, Boyd over the line. Fires that one on goal. It's handled by Connell. And Boyd took a slide into the end boards after that rush. Another nice look for Lacey Boyd, who has a pair of goals, of course. Both Bulldogs goals. Sparks with both for the Valley. And 2-2 is the score here as we approach the halfway point of this game. Marshall firing that one around the wall and stopped at the line there. Kept in again. And the Wild with the puck trying to carry it out. It's dumped into the neutral zone and the Bulldogs give chase. There's Jean on the puck for Antigonish. Jean plays that one up. It'll get out into the neutral zone and skating with it now is Boyd. Oh, sorry, that was Brooklyn Chisholm with the puck for the Bulldogs in deep. Comes back to the point now and thrown right on goal. A save there by Connell. A good play by Pellrein to get some rubber on net. 8 seconds left in the penalty to McCackern. So the Bulldogs killing this one off will have the benefit of being in the offensive zone to start this shift. Confusion here about the lines. And it's going to be Beaton and Chisholm out. It's the forward pair for this one. And the defender comes in to take that drop. Hellrein, one straight back, and that'll be smothered there by Connell. For another draw, 5 seconds left on the power play opportunity here. 7:50 to go in this second period of play. Puck in the corner and collected, wrapped off the boards and out into the neutral zone there by Cheek. Where Sparks is on it now for Valley. Sparks chips that one to an open zone and fires on goal. Nice save there. Rebound cleared away, almost right onto the stick of Bartow. Glenn now with the puck, cutting through the middle of the ice. Ailey Glenn driving wide and back to the middle. Glenn fires that one and it's kicked aside by Connell. Stopped at the line by Jean, who tries to fire that one back in deep, but it's kicked out by Sparks into the neutral zone, and the Bulldogs with possession given away there, though. But Pellrein comes up with it. Here's McDonald, one of a few McDonalds on this team. That's Emerson McDonald for the Bulldogs, clearing it into the neutral zone. And after that scramble along the near wall, another McDonald comes out with it there. That's Maya McDonald throwing that one in, but skated in offside. And another whistle here with 6:24 on the clock in period number two. Of course, we've seen a great game here so far from Tanaeus Sparks. For the Valley Wild, no surprise there if you followed the regular season at all. She finished with 157 points this season. I don't know how many games they played. I don't think it matters because that's a crazy number regardless. Bulldogs in the attacking zone. That'll be stopped at the line there and played in deep by Pinkos. Ross now at center ice with it for the Bulldogs, playing it over to the open wing. And for Maddie Joe Pinkos, who gets that one into the attacking zone and skating that one towards the goal now, right in front. And it's going to be knocked out and carried out over the line now. The Wild on the attack. That one's fired towards the goal there. and just steered aside by Elsa Cameron. In goal for Antigonish. Nice play to recover that one there. That's Julia Murray for the Bulldogs, playing that one towards the goal. It's into the corner and back up the half wall where it's fired back down, right on goal, kicked aside there by Emily Connell. That one's dumped in deep there. And Ross is back to collect for the Bulldogs. Karis Ross. Beaten there, fighting for that one. It's turned over and fired towards the goal by Chisholm. Bulldogs trying to keep the play alive in the attacking zone, and they will. There's Beaton trying to fire that one towards the goal, but that's going to be dropped onto the stick of the defender there, cleared down the ice. But the Bulldogs, again, as Beaton leads the charge, but offside as the Rat crossed the blue line ahead of play. 3:59 left in this second period. Puck played into the corner there. Chisholm trying to fire that one on goal, but Sparks carries it through the neutral zone. They converge on her. And Sparks remains on the ice here. Ref will blow the play dead and get some medical attention on the ice here. 3:37 to go in this second period. Sparks will get back to her feet and skate off under her own power. Good to see. Bulldogs players having a bit of fun on the bench there, getting their groove on as we wait to resume this game here in second period action. Again, 3:37 to play here. Period number two, Bulldogs out shooting the Valley Wild, 16-7 in this one. Into the neutral zone, and coming across for that one is Elizabeth McCachran. Weaving through the neutral zone, McCachran working up some speed there, hanging on to it, good puck control. McCachran walks in and fires that one on goal. A nice save by Connell, kicked into the corner. Bulldogs still with it, thrown towards the goal by Chisholm, and that's deflected into the corner. They give chase, it's thrown back cross ice, and McCachran firing that one in from the blue line. Doesn't get very far. And that puck comes loose. The Wild were on a change there, but couldn't capitalize. As it's McCachran picking it up again and dumping that one in deep. Alco played that one up the boards, and momentum carried her into her check there, and that's going to be a penalty call on that one for a body check. So another power play opportunity for the Bulldogs here as Alco will go to serve that one. Face off to the right of Connell. Glenn's in there to take it for the Bulldogs. And the Wild had an extra skater on the ice. They'll send her off and drop the puck here. Played over to the half wall. The Bulldogs going to collect that one. It's fired in on goal. McDonald there. Couple of chances to fire that one towards the net, but it's laid in behind, and the Bulldogs still on it there, down low. And that is played out to the blue line, kept in there. That was Pellerin making the play on the puck. Glenn firing that one just wide, and the Bulldogs back on it again. Emerson McDonald playing that one into heavy traffic and fired on goal there by Pellerin. It's wide. Glenn on in deep, harassing the puck carrier for the Wild. And they turn that one right back around. Successful zone time here. Bulldogs would like to see some more shots, I'm sure. 55 seconds left in this penalty. And just under 90 seconds to go in period number two. That one is finally going to be lifted and cleared down the ice by Valley Wild. Bulldogs giving chase here. Boyd in on it, I believe that is, for the Bulldogs. And Glenn back up the wall. There's Pellerin firing it. Hit some shin pads, but the Bulldogs still with the puck. It'll be cleared out to the neutral zone now. And poke check there. Into the final minute of play here, period number two. Bulldogs in with one last rush here on the power play. But the Valley Wild turning it back up the ice. There's Vene. Shot attempt rolls into the corner. The Bulldogs will throw that one right back around, but it's stopped at the half wall and played back into center ice there for Barteau. Lost it. Back down the ice for an icing call with 11.7 to play. In period number two, 2-2 is the score between these teams. Both goals from Valley coming in the first period. From Tanea Sparks, their captain. Back on the ice out there after getting shaken up on an earlier shift. And both goals for the Bulldogs. Also scored by the same player, Lacey Boyd. The contributor on those for the Bulldogs. Both of those players have looked great so far in this one. Lots of speed. And the Bulldogs have it now with Ross trying to charge up for one final shot. Can't quite get there, and the buzzer goes for the end of second period play. 2-2 the score between the Antigonish Bulldogs and the Valley Wild in this female Adam A. Provincial Championship game. We've got third period action on the way in just a few moments' time for you on 5TV1, brought to you by Bell Alliance from the 2017 RBC Day of Champions in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. Good morning once again from the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. We are here for female Adam A action. As we get set for puck drop here for period number three, the Antigonish Bulldogs and Valley Wild knotted up at two goals apiece. Heading into this third period here, Cameron McCachran along with you on 5TV1, brought to you by Bell Alliance. As these two teams are set to determine the next 15 minutes, maybe a little more if we're lucky, who is the Adam A champion. Here's Elizabeth McCachran walking in, and a great shot on goal, and a nice rush there by the mobile defender for the Bulldogs right off the hop. Bulldogs now controlling at the point. Will be fired down low and thrown towards the goal, but deflected into the corner. There's Boyd on the puck. Boyd with a pair of goals for the Bulldogs, and the Valley goal scorer on the puck there. Tania Sparks also with a pair. Behind her net is Ava Cheek, trying to set that one up, but it rolls to the defender there. Emily DeLore tries to put that one through a maze of bodies, but it's turned over, and here comes Sparks. Tania Sparks going for the hat trick, and a great back check on that one to break up the play. Excellent work there by the smooth-skating Elizabeth McCachran, who has certainly taken it upon herself at times to shut down the very talented Sparks. Has the skating ability to match, and she has the puck now. McCachran will dump that one down the ice into the neutral zone, where it's onto the stick of Alco. That's dumped deep into the Bulldogs' end and collected again by McCachran, who just rifles that around the wall. And back into Wild possession. That's Cheek. Was on the puck there for Valley. And Boyd coming out with it off the wall now for the Bulldogs. Lacey Boyd in over the line and weaving around a couple of defenders. A nice chance there. Good stop by Connell. Bulldogs back on it. Beaton centering pass for Boyd, who fires that one just wide. Great opportunity there for Lacey Boyd to notch the hat trick. Puck deep in the Valley zone. Beaten on the forecheck causes the turnover there. Backhands it towards the goal, and it's wide. And now the Valley Wild trying to skate that one out. Doesn't get too far, and the Bulldogs back on it. Very strong start for this squad from Antigonish here in period number three. Beaten over the line. That one broken up there, but held in once again at the blue line. The Bulldogs with a good opportunity there, and a good play by Pellrine to hang on to that one. And now Valley finally able to clear that one into neutral ice, but it's the Bulldogs on it again. Jenna Beaton over the line for Chisholm. There's Brooklyn Chisholm throwing it towards the goal, and it's played into the corner now by Valley. Whacking away at that puck there was Rhianne Jean. And it's on to the stick now for Lerat walking in and shooting that one. And it'll be sticked aside there by Connell into the corner. There's Vene carrying the puck for Valley. For the winger, that one going to be rattled off the boards and out into the neutral zone. And the Bulldogs right back on it. This puck has hardly crossed the red line in this one. It's been all Bulldogs in the early going of this third period of play, but here are the Wild turned over. Bulldogs back again. Brooklyn Chisholm carrying the puck in with speed, and it makes a nice move there to cross the ice and open up a shooting lane. Deflected in behind the net. And back to the point there where it's stopped by Ross and fired back down the wall. Here comes Sparks on it, but that's a nice play there to break that play up. Sparks with it again. On the wall here It's Glenn skating that one to the line, but loses the handle on it just inside the zone. Here's Ross up the left side, still carrying it. Ross plays that one right through the crease. No one there to tap it in. Bulldogs back on it now. Alyssa McDonald into the center ice there for Glenn. Takes the shot. That one's covered up by Emily Connell for a whistle. Visit tv1.bellalliant.ca for the TV1 Live webcast schedule and on-demand content. You'll get information on TV1 Live events available only to Bell Alliant 5 customers in Atlantic Canada on Channel 1 and 401. 5 TV is brought to you by Bell Alliant. Marshall fired that one off the wall, but not out. It's into the center of the ice now, and that one deflected in on goal. Connell pokes that into the corner, and Valley trying to regroup. Sparks giving chase. Tania Sparks with the puck now, down behind the Antigonish goal line. There's Ross playing that one back around the wall. And into the center of the ice where the Bulldogs will pick it up once again. Nice move there at center. Walking in with it is Emerson McDonald. And here's Sparks. She gathers it up. Stripped, though, on a nice play there by Glenn walking into the zone. Glenn with a great play to get the shot off on that one, and a nice save by Connell. And this one remains knotted at two apiece. Bulldogs on it now. There's Alyssa McDonald dumping that one down. Sparks with it here. Good back check there by Glenn, who's had a couple of nice plays on the talented Sparks to limit her time and space. In over the line, firing that one towards the goal is Julia Murray. Right in front there, and that's going to be jumped on by Emily Connell and smothered for another faceoff. 8:20 to play in the third period. A 2-2 hockey game. Mentioned that there are a few McDonalds on this team. Emerson McDonald being one. Emerson's dad is the coach of this Adam A. Bulldogs squad. Maybe a familiar name to some. Craig McDonald, veteran of 233 NHL games with several organizations, including the Blackhawks and the Hurricanes and the Bruins and a number of others. Craig is the head coach for this Bulldogs team. Nice to have a little NHL experience behind the bench, I'm sure. The Dogs breaking it out here. That one rolls all the way down the ice and back to play that one around the boards. Is Cheek. Sorry, that was Alco, rather. Cheek with it now behind the net, but that's played out front by the Bulldogs. It's gobbled up again by Connell and smothered for another faceoff here. 7:21 to play in the third period. Shots on goal 22-7 in favor of the Antigonish Bulldogs in this one. Beaton wins that draw back to Jean, who plays it over to an open wing. Shot there from Pellerine is blocked in front by Sparks. And the Wild finally able to corral that one. It's fired down the ice in a foot race now as Sparks is bearing down on that one, and some good work there by Rianne Jean to hold off the speedy Sparks. And now skating it up the ice is Jean all the way in. Jean will fire that one right on. And a nice save there by Connell, who has been a wall back there. Very solid between the pipes for the Valley Wild. Nice rush there after the good defensive play by Rianne Jean. Lions faceoff is to the right of Connell. And a draw won by the Bulldogs. Back to the point where Pellron is going to try to fire that one through. It's blocked. Sparks back on the rush. Good work there by Pellron to get back. And another nice poke there. Some great shutdown defense by the Antigonish Bulldogs happening here on the clear top threat for the Valley Wild. Tania Sparks, two goals already tonight. And the Bulldogs aren't giving her much room to move here in this third period of play. Fired towards the goal, picked off again. The Bulldogs try to get that one out. Here it is in the skates. And skated out now by Beaton, throwing that one on goal along the ice. That one is stopped and smothered by Emily Connell with another save for the Valley Wild. And out comes the Glenn line. Ailey Glenn has had some great looks so far for the Bulldogs in this one. And they control off the draw. McDonald for Glenn taking the shot there. It's blocked. McDonald firing it through. It's blocked also. And backhanded down. Here are the Valley Wild once again. Hearing that one behind the net. It's going to be fired down the ice. It'll go all the way. And no icing. So that's played by the goaltender. Bulldogs back with it now. Here's Ross. Over the blue line. Ross working in. McDonald firing a shot. That one just wide. And Glenn on it now, throwing it out front. That one just didn't settle down. For McDonald, and a nice shot there with a great glove save. Emily Connell flashing a little bit of leather. Had a little flair to her performance here this morning. She's had a great game so far. That's the 25th shot she's faced. She stopped 23 of those, so having a very impressive performance between the pipes for the Valley Wild here. Boyd with a pair of goals for the Bulldogs, and to take the draw for Antigonish. That's one through by Sparks. But the Bulldogs retain it. Now out into the neutral zone, where McCachran will rifle that one back down into the zone, and it's picked up here by Alco. Skated behind her net, Brooke Alco. Tries to make a breakout pass there. It's picked off by Boyd. A nice move on Alco to open up some room. Boyd walks in, takes the shot. A rebound is leapt on there by Connell with another save. Shutting the five hole on that one. It was Lacey Boyd trying to notch the hat trick here in this one. It has been the weekend of hat tricks at the RBC Day of Champions. We have seen 11 games. This is a game number 12. And this is just a rough estimation, but we've only seen probably two or three games of the 11 so far that haven't featured at least one hat trick. So a couple of players with two goals in this one. We'll see where it goes in the last 4 minutes and 34 seconds as Connell smothers another one there. Faceoff will come to her right. Boyd is there waiting and primed for the faceoff. Puck is sent all the way down the ice for an icing call. That's charged against the Valley Wild. And the Bulldogs have been carrying the play, particularly here in this third period. Really putting the pressure on, and Emily Connell has had a fantastic outing in the goal for Valley. Battle for the puck here. Four Bulldogs converge on it, and it's played out to the one who hadn't. That one's going to be fired up the wall. And dumped again down from the wrong side of center ice for another icing charge against Valley, and another draw to the right of Emily Connell. 4:06 to play here, period number three. Shots 26-7 in favor of the Antigonish Bulldogs.
Puck behind the Valley net. Defender coming up with that one and firing that down the ice there. And back on it now. Trying once again to break that one out is Isabel Britton. Fires it up the wall, and that one will squirt out to center ice, where it's gathered up and fired back down the ice by Jean. And the Wild trying to mount a rush here. 3:20 remaining in the third period of play. It's turned over to Jean. Rianne Jean skating with it. Backhands it up the wall. And that one will be fired down for another icing call here. This one against the Antigonish Bulldogs. And the draw coming back into the Dogs zone. Into crunch time at the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center. 2-2 the score with 3:06 to play here in period number 3 of this Adam A. Female Championship game, the RBC Day of Champions. Game number 1 on day 3, the final day of action here at in Bridgewater. Great weekend of hockey. Lots of happy folks. Lots of disappointed folks too, of course. And we've got an exciting one going here, and now it's going to be a huge opportunity. With 2:51 on the clock, the Antigonish Bulldogs will go to the power play. And not only that, but the Valley Wild will be without their captain and top player, Tania Sparks, who takes the call there. She'll sit for two or less. So that's one threat off the ice, and a good chance here for the Bulldogs to take the lead in the last few minutes of this game. Again, 2:51 on the clock. That shot comes from Glenn. Fanned on, though, right off of the draw. Ailey Glenn tried to whip that one towards the goal. That'll be covered up, and another draw in the Valley zone. A little bit of strategy talk here between Glenn and McCachern. Back to McCachern at the point, and she'll throw it just wide into the corner here. And Valley trying to dump that one out. No call on that one as Glenn was hauled down trying to get a shot off. Cheek now backhanding that up the wall onto the tape there for Bartow. Can't get it out though. And it's Glenn back on it there. Ailey Glenn throwing it through open ice in the slot. McDonald behind the goal. Maya McDonald. That one's fired into the top corner. And the Antigonish Bulldogs take the lead. With 2:08 to play in this third period. A huge goal there. I believe that might be Ailey Glenn getting the credit for that one. So what a situation we have developing in this one. On the power play opportunity, the Antigonish Bulldogs take the lead for the first time in this game. And not a bad time to do it with just over shade over 2 minutes left on the clock. This will be a timeout call. They'll discuss strategy for this last flurry of plays here. So Bulldogs take the lead, and the Wild get Sparks back out of the box. And no doubt they'll try to get her the puck for as many looks as they can in the next 2 minutes or so here. Be interesting to see whether she leaves the ice at all. Two goals already in this one, and a threat to score many more Tania Sparks in this Adam A. provincial title game. Sparks wins that face-off through the legs, and Bulldogs knock it right back down. But Sparks collecting in the neutral zone here. And a run at Sparks there will result in another penalty, this one against the Bulldogs. A tripping call. Sparks had some speed coming through the neutral zone. She got hauled down, and now the Bulldogs will have to try to kill one off here. Emily DeLory going to serve two or less for this one with a minute 54 left in this third period. So the Valley Wild, a power play opportunity, trying to claw back into this one after that devastating late goal there by Ailey Glenn just moments ago. Now it's a chance for Valley, but here's McCachran bringing it the other way for the Bulldogs. Elizabeth McCachran, smooth skating defender, throws it out front, and that one's buried in front. A goal there for Lacey Boyd to complete the hat trick with a minute 40 remaining. And the Antigonish Bulldogs take a 4-2 lead now. A minute 40 on the clock. A shorthanded goal there for Lacey Boyd. She scored a goal in the first, a goal in the second, completes the hat trick here in the third, and couldn't come at a bigger time to put her Bulldogs out to a 2-goal lead late in this one, as a hat is fired onto the ice from the Antigonish cheering section in behind the benches there across the way. And now the effort to lock this one up begins for the Bulldogs. Sitting on a 2-goal lead, here's Sparks up the wall. Sparks will fire that one high. Back on the attack here, the Valley Wild backhanding that one toward the goal was Britton, but the Bulldogs with possession again, net empty. And in comes Boyd with three already. That one will go. And that was almost intercepted on the way to the net, but Lacey Boyd finishes that one off. And what a performance in this championship game. Lacey Boyd notches her fourth goal into an empty net, and that is going to lock this one up. 48 seconds to play. The Antigonish Bulldogs open up a 3-goal lead here in Bridgewater. They've been driving the play all night long, or all morning long. Shots 30-7 in favor of the Bulldogs here in this one. Not been much offensive opportunity for Valley in this third period, but they'll take another rush here on the way up the ice. That's Alco walking in and firing that one. And that one will squeeze through the pads and find the back of the net. Alco taking it on herself to rush that one up the ice, fires it, and just manages to find a little bit of daylight on the short side there on Elsa Cameron. So with 32.8 seconds left, Valley back within two. Maybe this one's not over just yet. Not surprisingly, Sparks out there to take the draw, and she's going to try to win this through the legs once again, I believe. She does. Can't break through, though. Bulldogs now just trying to kill this clock out. With 20 seconds remaining, the Wild will dump that one down, but that's going to roll all the way for an icing call with 15 seconds on the clock here. So a face-off all the way back to the Valley end. And they'll return the netminder, Connell, who has had an excellent night here. Result notwithstanding, she's faced a lot of pucks here this morning, and has stood tall, made a lot of key saves in the third period to keep Valley in it, but in the end, Bulldogs just overpowered her here in the third, but an excellent performance by Emily Connell. And the Bulldogs, another shot there as time ticks down. 7 seconds left, puck behind the goal. That one's going to come all the way out, and that will do it. The Antigonish Bulldogs are the 2017 Nova Scotia Female Adam A champions. They pile on to goaltender Elsa Cameron. And somewhere in that pile is Lacey Boyd, who scored four goals this morning to power this Bulldogs performance. 5-3 the final for the Antigonish Bulldogs over the Valley Wild to claim the female Adam A provincial banner. Craig McDonald and his staff will celebrate, and a big win for the girls here to cap off an excellent season. And again, a great performance as well by the Valley Wild, and in particular by a couple of players, Emily Connell, who stopped 26 shots here today, faced a lot of pucks for an Adam game. Great performance by Connell, and as well, their captain, Tanaya Sparks, who was the goal scorer twice over for the Valley Wild in this one, and a threat every time she was on the ice. But it was the Antigonish Bulldogs coming out on top here. Again, 5-3 the final for the Bulldogs over the Valley Wild in the female Adam A provincial title game from the 2017 RBC Day of Champions at the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. The teams shake hands, the Bulldogs will claim their banner, and we'll be back with more hockey action as the Day of Champions rolls on. Game number two for the morning is set for 11 o'clock, so we'll have the call for you here on 5TV1, brought to you by Bell Wyatt. It's the Adam AA title game coming up at 11 o'clock between the Fundy Highland Selects and the Metro West Force Blue. Hope you'll join us for the coverage of that game at 11 o'clock. Once again, Adam A, female champions, the Antigonish Bulldogs, as they celebrate here from the Lunenburg County Lifestyle Center in Bridgewater, Nova Scotia. I'm Cameron McCachran for 5TV1. We'll be back at 11.